All right, so I got some new movies here to show you. I have an Amazon, couple pre-orders, and then I have some Disney Movie Club stuff, and I'll talk about that in a minute. But I did get this Babylon poster from work. I did not like this movie. I do think this poster looks cool enough that I put it on the wall. Gonna have to find a place for that, but that's cool. Now let's get into the Amazon, should we get into the Amazon orders or just Disney? Disney Movie Club stuff. So like I said, I pre-ordered both these items. Alright, let's open this one up. So there's another Funko Gold figure. And this is Elvis. I'm a big Elvis fan. I absolutely adore Elvis. This figure is really cool. It's $10. I don't think it looks the greatest with the face and all that, but other than that, I think it looks cool. And it's an iconic look for Elvis, of course, so had to have that. And it was like $13-14 when I pre-ordered it. But when it was ready to ship out, it went down to $10, which is great. I don't think he's in stock on Amazon anymore, but you can check. So, good thing I pre-ordered him, because I think he sold out. So then I got Star Trek Prodigy, Season 1, Episodes 1 through 10. This is an awesome show. I've been reviewing it on my main channel, Chan's Movie Vlog channel, if you guys want to find it. And, it's an awesome show. I think it's really good. It's probably the best modern Star Trek show. So I pre-ordered the upcoming books. And the Blu-ray of the show, because again, I'm trying to get better about collecting seasons of shows, because once you start getting behind, it's so hard to catch up. So, but what I did not expect was we got cards here, collectible cards. I did not expect that. Now with these Star Trek shows, they don't do digital copies or anything like that, which I think is a little unfortunate, but it's whatever. Not that I was ever going to, like, use them. And to be honest, like, when it comes to Star Trek, I'm the only one in my house that actually likes Star Trek. For the most part, anyways. So I need to put this in Orioles. But, we'll see here. We got the whole crew on one. We got Del. I think that's Del. I forget. We got this girl here and Captain Janeway. So these are cool. I think with the next set, since this collectible set only has a few of the main characters, not all of them, you'll probably get the rest on cards next time. But yeah, this is really neat. And it is the 20th anniversary of Deep Space Nine, which I think is... I think that's the show that Janeway came from. I forget what name of all the different shows because all the episodes listed on the back. But yeah, Paramount Plus exclusive show. Getting a Blu-ray's always awesome to see. Paramount's really good about that. And it's an awesome, awesome show on Blu-ray now. Cannot wait to dive into that. And then this one right... Okay, so... Yeah, let's start with this box. So I signed up for the Disney Movie Club. And let me tell you why. I did it because... they have so many exclusive titles that I've literally wanted to come to Blu-ray for years. And they only have been exclusive to the club. And the thing is, I buy Disney in bulk anyways. I buy all these Disney titles on release day. They don't ever go down in price. I was looking on Black Friday, and a lot of those titles were still like $30-25. You know? And so that's why I just buy them at full price on release day, because they don't really go on sale, you know? So, basically, if you don't know how the Disney Movie Club works, it's a service that they give you a deal. You buy 4 movies for $1, free shipping, they give it to you. And then you have a contract with them that you must buy 5 movies at full price on the website. Which usually works out because if you're someone who buys a Disney movie, like, I don't know, like the new Black Panther movie, if you're going to buy that day one, then just order it from the club at full price. Cool. And what's great about it, also, if you order it from that website, you can get a second one with the percentage knocked off. So, and again, they have exclusive Blu-rays and stuff. So I started this club. I picked my four titles. And then they gave me the option of getting one title for 15 and the other for 10. So, that means I have six titles here to show you. Four of which being exclusives. The other two I just didn't have. So, first one up, there's only one with the slipcover, Lion King 2, Simba's Pride. I have Lion King, the original on 4K, and I have 1.5. So I didn't have Lion King 2, so this completes my set. That's why I grabbed it. And this one's a little bit harder to find than the other two. So I'm glad I was able to grab it from their website, at least. If I can get this open. Do I have a sharp object anywhere near me that I can use? Whatever. Man, this is not going to want to open. Okay, here we go. Sorry. I need to get an unboxing knife for some of this stuff, just so I can open this stuff easier and more efficiently on camera if I'm going to keep unboxing stuff. But right now, first, you get the Disney movie Insider's Points. Oh, shit. The DVD immediately fell out. That's annoying, but DVD and Blu-ray there. Nothing too fancy. You can get this one non-exclusive to the club, but, you know, this one's harder to find, so I don't know. But, yeah, you get Lion King 1 and 2, and then you get Lion King 1.5. That set, look at that. Set looks really nice together, so I'm glad to have a complete set there. I grabbed Fox and the Hound 1 and 2. I have not seen this one in a really long time. I don't remember it really grabbing me as a kid, just because this is a very adult story, you know, in a way. So I don't know. I remember it being sad, but I don't remember anything much about it. But he got Fox and the Hound 1 and 2 on one Blu-ray disc. I don't think I've ever seen Fox and the Hound 1 and 2. Probably have. Probably just don't remember because it's not good. This one's a fun one. The Black Cauldron. The Black Cauldron. Now we're getting into the club exclusives. So this is one of Disney's biggest bombs of all time. And when it comes to their animated movies, I think Strange World, Treasure Planet, those beat it, but this is one of their biggest ones. It is. I love this movie in a weird way because it is kind of on different. Not everybody's thing. It is kind of not the greatest movie. It's definitely bad, but I do have a soft spot for this one. And I find it a fun film. I like fantasy. Maybe that's just me. You know, there are two genres I have a soft spot for, which is fantasy and sci-fi. So it really takes a lot for me to not like a sci-fi or a fantasy show or a movie or whatever. So, but this one here is another example of a fantasy or sci-fi movie that I have a soft spot for that's not good. Black Hole. Maximilian in this movie is creepy. This is a crazy sci-fi movie about, you know, these people headed into a black hole or something. I forget the whole details of it. But yeah, fantastic movie to me. It's got a lot of issues. You know, it's kind of trying to be Disney's Star Wars. Didn't really work out that well. It's just so weird to say it was trying to be Disney's Star Wars because now they freaking own Star Wars. You know? Like they went from ripping off Star Wars to owning their ass. Kind of funny, but This one was the one I was most excited about. This is one of my favorite movies. Goofy movie. This is, I'm sorry, if you don't know, this movie was not made by Disney. Walt Animation Studios was made by Disney Toon. And this is better than some mainline Disney animated features. This movie is 10 out of 10 to me. Absolute banger. Love this one. So excited to have that. Though honestly, some of these club exclusives, like, I don't see them put out a Black Hole Blu-ray in a store and it's selling like a bunch of copies. But I don't understand a Goofy movie. You can't tell me if they didn't put that in a store, it would sell. You know, they had to kick people out of the Goofy movie panel at D23 because there were so many people that they couldn't allow them in. So that's how popular this movie is. Putting a Blu-ray in a store would have been nice, but they will probably never do that. I did order the sequel, an Extremely Goofy Movie, because that's also a club exclusive Blu-ray. It's on its way to me at the moment. So, and then the last one, before we get into the last title here, is the movie Holes. I don't remember loving this one, but basically when I ordered my four movies for a dollar, they gave me a couple options of random movies. And this was the only one that I had interest in, Holes. I probably would have grabbed this at some point anyways, but would have been like in the far future. It wouldn't have been a main grab. Because I think I've tried to watch this one a couple times as a kid and found it boring. Maybe I'll like it now, because it kind of is a classic for a lot of people, but I've never been crazy about it. So hopefully I will really like that one if I watch it now. This last one here, this was a pre-order. And I actually have three movies on pre-order from them. One of which not coming till February, and then two of them not coming till towards the end of this month of January. So but this one, I've heard great things about this movie. I wanted to see this in theaters, but it was playing in very limited release. Never came to a theater near me, but it is nominated for a bunch of awards and things, and it is got Colin Farrell in it, who I love, Colin Farrell, and that is The Banshees of Inisherin? You hear it? I'm not really sure how you pronounce that. It's got Domhnall Gleeson, or Brendan Gleeson. And yeah, it looks really good. I've heard amazing things about this movie. I've never seen it. But I paid $17 with it. And again, like I mentioned, so when you order stuff from them, they give you a deal of like, oh, you order this one, then you can get another one, a little percentage knocked off. And the one I ordered with it knocked off was a pre-order, so that's not coming until later. But usually, most of the time when I pre-order something, my plan is just to order a club exclusive so I can just knock off that list eventually. And when I knock off that list of all the club exclusives I want, I'll probably just cancel. Just because, you know, I don't know. But I have six titles here. And yeah, this was all like, so the six titles I paid in total were $30, shipping, tax included. And then this was $17, which is not bad because that's basically what this is going for in the store. So, and that's with shipping and tax included in that one as well. So, yeah, good deals. Got all that. And thank you guys for watching. Like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.